Hey guys, and welcome to the Rav07 channel. Today we have an unboxing and review of the 2010 Apple iPod Shuffle. So in September 2010, the new iPod Shuffle was announced, and today we will unbox the new device before giving you our final review of the product. So here we have the box, and like the actual device, it is also very small. Now I'm just going to go ahead and remove the white cellophane. So on top, the box is actually transparent, so we can see the iPod Shuffle inside. On the front we have some serial code information. On the side we have iPod Shuffle, and it's also the same on the left. On top we have the Apple logo, and on the back we have the capacity, which is 2 gigabytes, and also some Apple small print. So let's go ahead and open the box. There is a small tab here, and we're just going to simply pull it. And let's go ahead and open it up. So straight away on top we have the actual iPod, which is very, very tiny. And if we just pull this tab, we can simply remove the plastic. So let's put this to one side, and we will be coming back and removing this handset in a short while. So what else do we get inside the box? Well, first of all we have the start here, which consists of some user manuals and other information. We also have the infamous Apple stickers. Important product information, which is, you know, a load of garbage in my opinion. Don't really read that. In terms of accessories, we get the bog standard Apple in-ear headphones, which do not incorporate any voice control or push buttons. And finally we have the USB to 3.5mm adapter, which allows you to connect to the computer in order to sync and charge the iPod Shuffle. So now let's take a closer look at the 2010 Apple iPod Shuffle. So the Shuffle is well known for being small and affordable, and this version is no different. The device is available for $49 in the US, or £39 if you're here in the UK. The 4 GB version has been scrapped by Apple, meaning you can only get the device in 2 GB, which should uphold approximately 500 songs. In addition to this classy silver combination, the iPod Shuffle is also available in blue, pink, orange, and green. Now, in terms of design and functionality, it's clear to see that Apple have taken inspiration from the two previous versions. The clickable control pad has been taken from the second generation, but at the same time, the new 2010 Shuffle still looks as sleek as the third generation. In terms of size, the iPod is extremely small, measuring just 29mm in height, 31mm in width, and a thickness of just under 9mm. The body of the Shuffle has been constructed from a single piece of polished aluminium, and despite having a weight of just 12 grams, the device feels solid and durable, which is something which can be seen in most Apple products. So let's go ahead and tour the device. On the front we have the black control click wheel with a play pause button in the middle, volume up at the top, volume down, rewind and previous, and next track or fast forward. At the top of the device we have a switch. When switched to the right position, the device will be powered off. When on the left, it will play music in shuffle mode. And when in the middle, it will play music in order. Just next to that, we have the voiceover button. Now, voiceover was featured in the previous generation iPod Shuffle. However, most people agree it wasn't implemented correctly, because you actually had to use the headphones in order to be able to use the device. However, Apple have seemed to get it right with the 2010 Shuffle, and using the voice functionality is very simple. All we have to do is press once to hear the current track and artist, press and hold to hear the playlist menu, and press twice to hear the battery status. On the back we have an Apple logo as well as a very strong clip, which allows us to attach the Shuffle to clothing, backpacks and other personal items. The clip has a very strong spring, and I would imagine that it would last a pretty long time. So overall, what do we think about the new 4th generation iPod Shuffle? Well, it's pretty clear Apple have learnt from their mistake. Although the 2009 model wasn't bad, it certainly sacrificed functionality for size, but fortunately the new version seems to have a nice balance of both. The strangest thing is the absence of a 4GB model. On one hand, it means you can't store as many songs as you'd like to, but to be honest, 2GB of music should be plenty for a cheap on-the-go iPod. So is the iPod Shuffle for you? Well, if you like to have all of your music on one device, then probably not, but it would definitely be ideal for those needing a small and durable MP3 player for the gym or commuting. So thanks for watching, we hope you enjoyed this review. Please remember to like, comment and subscribe, and stay tuned to the Ravo7 channel for more technology reviews.